Hello, and welcome to FSM News. I'm Dominique Peters.
And I'm Marquise Brown. FSM News is a product of Free Spirit Media, which is a nonprofit organization that empowers youth voice.
Free Spirit Media, in partnership with the Gary Comer Youth Center, After School Matters, and the Medill School of Journalism, present FSM News on Hoops High.
Many people want to start their new year with a fresh start. Some decide to make New Year's resolutions for themselves.
FSM's Shamicia Davis has more on the most popular resolutions.
It's a new year, and many people are making New Year resolutions. But can those resolutions be taken seriously and well thought out? I decided to find out what resolutions some people are making this year and how they plan to stick with them.
2010 is here, and resolutions have started.
My New Year's resolution is to get a better group of friends,
to join a softball team in my school,
to be the best track star,
to maintain higher than a 3.5.
New Year's is so much fun. In the midst of all the excitement, it's easy to set goals for the new year. But most people find it hard to stick with their resolutions.
Because maybe they choose a bigger goal that they can achieve all in one setting.
Because they probably don't have enough faith in themselves and like they have other people or they just most likely forget about it.
Okay. If you're having a hard time sticking with your goals, try some of these helpful tips. Write down your resolution in a place that's easy to see. Think ahead and create a plan for the whole year. Good luck. I'm Shamicia Davis reporting for FSM News.
This is a very exciting time of the year. For more information on good New Year resolutions, go to mygoals.com.
Thanks for enjoying our show so far.
We will be right back with a story on youth violence.
Welcome back to FSM News.
Do you feel safe in your neighborhood? Lately, violence has been a major issue in our community. The death rates are steadily increasing. FSM's Shakiba Ransom has more on the story.
The issue of youth violence is growing increasingly worse in Chicago, but some teens are taking a stand against it. Take a look and see how some students are getting together after school to express how youth violence affects them.
A group of teens are getting involved to help stop violence in their community. They call themselves PACE, a unique, entertaining, and educational experience. With the recent growth of youth violence in our community, more teens are now cautious and becoming more aware of their surroundings.
Now I have to worry about whether or not I'm going to actually make it home, or are my brothers going to make it home, or even if my mom's going
to
make it home.
As the issue of youth violence continues to increase in our community, some teens are taking on the responsibility to speak out through a creative stage play. The audience, mainly made up of youth members at the Gary Comer Youth Center, were drawn to the play.
You know what? You ain't the only person he making mad. Now, I told him that he needs to stop running these streets like a little knucklehead.
Many of them left more aware and inspired.
Well, I learned that you just gotta walk away from certain stuff.
All these gang people and everything are just messing up our neighborhood more and killing all our CPS students, and that's not good.
I'm just hoping that the kids will take back control of their lives, to take control, and just to say that we're not going to let this happen, because if the kids don't care about themselves, then who will?
PACE is a very ambitious organization, and their work doesn't stop here. In the future, they plan to have many performances throughout the city of Chicago, at the University of Chicago, local hospitals, and other schools. Reporting for FSM News, I'm Shakiva Ransom.
Youth involvement PACE strive to be the advocates for themselves and their communities. To request more information about the program, email PACEChicago@yahoo.com. That's P-A-E-C-E Chicago@yahoo.com.
Some teens may find it difficult to abstain from having sex.
But is it the safest solution? Up next in Teen Talk, we'll hear more about teen pregnancy and abstinence. Here is Sterling Hill and Kimani Cannon with more.
Teen pregnancy is an ever-growing problem within our community.
There have been many solutions to decrease the rate of teen pregnancy, one solution being abstinence.
We wanted to know what you thought on Facebook, so we placed the question, is abstinence a realistic solution to teen pregnancy? Orlandis Thomas said yes, because there are so many other things that teens could be focused on other than sex.
We also wanted some more feedback, so check this out.
Everywhere you go, teens are talking about sex. Unfortunately, some teens aren't just talking about it. The rate of teen pregnancy has skyrocketed. This year alone, statistics show that 3 out of 5 teen girls will become pregnant. What can be done to prevent this? Abstinence is the best solution, but will teens make the right choice?
People, they might, just if your partner don't want to do it, then they might not do it because they think they're going to lose out on that person.
Very difficult because when you're around a lot of friends and your peers and everyone's talking about it and discussing it and you feel like that you're not involved in it because of it, then it puts more pressure on you to feel like that you need to go do that to fit in with your crowd.
In the Bible, God asks to stay a virgin until marriage, so I just go by God says and I go by my religion.
For more information about abstinence, please visit www.abstinenceassociation.org.
And don't forget to comment on our discussion board on Facebook. Look us up as FSM News.
Hey Dominique, why did the chicken cross the road?
Well, Mikey's, he was just hungry, so he wanted some chicken fingers.
No, because he wanted to see the story coming up next. Stay tuned, we'll be back with sports.
Last year, I couldn't choose what to do.
I had trouble fitting in.
And I hated vegetables.
But this year is a new year.
It's a new me.
And I'm sticking with it.
You're watching FSM News. Thanks for staying with us.
In our next story, we'll hear about the men behind the players, the coaches.
What does it take to be a good basketball coach? Coach Orlandis Thomas of the Gary Coleman College Prep Catamounts has an answer.
It's a lot of practice planning hours. It's a lot of hard work. It's a lot of long hours. Okay, you're responsible for developing the athletic ability of your athletes and your student athletes.
Dedication to his players is his number one key. He says coaching is more than just X's and O's. It takes time, both on and off the court.
Which will get you in foul trouble, which will get you limit your own minutes because you are half.
Since high school, Coach Thomas knew that a career as a basketball coach was in his future. He reached the goal at just 22. The points and steals that his players make aren't what satisfies him the most. He values something much greater.
When the students, you know, when they get to juniors and seniors and you see the payoff and they're getting scholarships or they leave your program as model students and great character guys, that's when that all that hard work pays off.
Despite the grueling practices and endless drills, the players respect and admire their coach.
He's a very dedicated coach. He comes out every morning. He wakes up at like 3:30 in the morning.
In a few seconds, I'll be taking on the task of seeing what it takes to be a good coach.
Okay, we're gonna run 17 in a minute, starting now.
Go to whistle.
Oh, start over, sorry.
Oh,
let's
do it.
All right, we're gonna run 17s in 1 minute. All right, let's go, guys, let's go.
If you think there's a coach in you, just remember to have one thing.
Coaching is a passion.
Reporting for FSM News, I'm Marshawn Crosby.
Well, now it's time for the show to come to an end.
We hope you all enjoyed the latest news from Free Spirit Media.
Until next time, I'm Marquise Brown.
And I'm Dominique Peters.
See ya. Well, Dominique, what are you doing over the winter break?